What is going on, everybody? My name is All17, and welcome to Subnautica. Alright, so I know what you're thinking. Why would I say welcome to Subnautica when I played this game on my channel before? Well, guys, if you might want to take a look, I actually unlisted the first video of this, series. Just because I wanted to start fresh, I wanted to start anew. And the only reason I'm actually playing this now is because, one of my friends actually, saw this on my channel and wanted me to continue it. So, yeah, that's why I'm here. That's pretty much why I'm playing this game right now. I wasn't actually planning on continuing the series. Well, I'm going to turn this down a little bit more. I thought I had it at just the right volume, but I think 10% is the magic number here. But, like I said, I wasn't planning on continuing the series because, quite honestly, I'm not exactly great at this type of game. But, I mean, I figured I might as well anyway, and let's see how far we can get. So, what we're going to do, we're going to start fresh, we're going to start new, and we are going to create ourselves a new world in survival. Okay, so survival mode is definitely what we're going for. Hunger and thirst to survive, yes, yes. And, of course, we're going to have to find some resources as well. And I'll be right back once the game loads in. Alright, let's do this thing. We start off with a little introduction. We are currently falling from space right now in a life pod, so I can't look around right now, but that right there, that's the Aurora. That is the ship that we are going to be looking at for quite some time. Oh no, this seems dangerous. And boom. That is very painful. Yet, remarkably, we managed to survive that, taking a giant scrap of metal to the face. Okay, and also, no telling how long this fire has been here, just tearing out the insides of this place, but, yeah. Let's go ahead and take this thing out, and there we go. We are now in the life pod, and we are ready to begin. Okay, so I don't remember a lot about this game. I never got very far before. I have a lot to learn about it. Let's just say that, okay? Yeah, yeah, I know. Initializing the PDA, that's nice. Okay. Thank you. Okay. I am familiar with it, thank you. Okay, anyway, so here we are. We start out in a life pod, and pretty much what this game is, if you don't know a thing about this game, this is a survival game, and it takes place in an ocean. And it is terrifying, and when I say terrifying, it is absolutely terrifying. It might, I keep pausing the game, I keep forgetting it's tab to get out of the inventory. But it might seem friendly at first, looking around, but it's not. This place is deadly, and we are going to fail in here so hard. Here we are. So this is what we're given. We start off in some nice shallow waters, and of course we have to survive. We have to find water, we have to find food, and we have to do some exploring. Okay, so first things first, I want to actually make a couple batteries. So I think we need a couple of these mushrooms here. And we're also going to need some to find some copper. Hopefully we can find that pretty quick. Let's see what's in this limestone. Come on, give me copper. Look at that, copper right off the bat. Wow, that was lucky. So we can already make a battery. Okay, and yes, we do have to worry about our oxygen. We only have so long that we can be down here. There we go, and I actually almost drowned right there. I need to be a lot more careful. And I see something over there. I don't know what that is. That's definitely not where we started. This is actually our life pod right here. That one, it looks like it's another life pod, but it's actually very, very close. So I might actually do some exploring out that way. But for now, we need to worry about actually starting the game and actually getting some resources and actually trying to survive on here. Okay, so we have a fabricator. This is pretty much our crafting system. We got resources which we can make, basic materials, all the stuff here, which we need to get a lot of stuff in order to make any of this. We have the advanced materials, which I still don't know what any of this stuff does. Then we have the electronics, which we can make a battery right off the bat. And let's go ahead and make that. And we are going to need this for, which one did we need first? Probably the flashlight, either the flashlight or the, oh, I can't use the sea glide yet because I need to find the fragments, dang. Okay, beacon, deployable, waterproof locker, grab sphere, uses artificial grab, okay, attract light objects. That's cool, but not really all that interesting. Let's see, repair tool, that we need. Flashlight, we need some glass now in order to make the flashlight. Survival knife, habitat builder, which that's something we'll get into quite a bit along down the road, assuming we make it that far. We also have the scanner, which can be, actually that's what we need first is the scanner, because the scanner will help us find the fragments that we can use to make additional items, additional tools and all sorts of stuff that we're going to need. Like the sea glide, which is going to be one of the first ones by far that we construct. Okay, so nutrient block, we need that. There I go again. How do I put this? Or actually, I think I just have to double tap it. Yeah, I do. Okay, there we go. I need to quit hitting the escape button. All right, so let's go for a dive, shall we? Down we go. Woo! Oh, man, this is freaky. That thing right there, I already know is dangerous. I'm staying away from him. Actually, let me go ahead and get close just to show what he does. That is what he does right there. Those little gas pods, those things are deadly. So, yeah. Right off the bat, we have some danger. We need to be careful. And hopefully there's not too many of those guys around here because I don't like them. Okay, we got ourselves some metal. That's definitely something we need. We need the metal to make the titanium. The only thing is, it takes up a ton of space in our inventory, so we can't pick up too much of it. Oh, yeah. Actually, I need the oxygen tank, like, immediately. Because, look, I'm not even going that far down, and I'm already almost drowning. So, oxygen tank, you're going to be my very, very first thing we craft. Okay, so, let's see. Fabricator. Oh, medical kit fabricator. I forgot about that. Let's go ahead and pick that up, and even if we don't need it at the moment, I can store that. Oops, I just used it. Oh, well. We're full on health now. Ugh, dang it. Okay, so what do we need to make the oxygen tank? I guess what we're going to do to progress in this game is try and figure out what we need and I guess get the items that we need in order to progress. That's all I can think because I never got very far with this game. I never have. I would like to, but I just don't know what to do. Fire extinguisher, we have that. We don't need. We can actually craft medical kits. Still suit, ingredients unknown, radiation suit, we will need that later. That's another thing I want to make is fins, but the oxygen tank, we need two titanium and some glass. The titanium we can actually go ahead and make using our raw resources, basic materials, titanium, and one metal salvage makes four of them, which is really, really cool. Let's go ahead and just smelt that all into titanium, or smelt it, or craft it, or whatever it is, use those lasers to make it for us. Okay, so we can also, let's see, now all, actually I think all we need is glass. What do we need for glass? Basic materials, titanium ingot, we don't really need silicone. Okay, we need quartz. We need two quartz and I have one already. So yeah, that's pretty much what the first episode is just going to be, nothing but gathering resources. So bear with me, guys, bear with me. When it comes to games like this, starting off is always very, very slow because yes, thank you. But starting off is always so difficult because you have to worry about gathering the resources and it's very slow going and ooh, what kind of fish is that? Okay, we actually need to resurface. Actually, we were good on oxygen, but just in case. Let's see. That should be enough, but I do kind of want to take a look at my surroundings. Ooh, we got something over here. This is why we need the scanner, though, because, okay, if you notice, oh, that's a sea glide fragment, but I can't scan it yet. Once we're able to scan it, we can actually collect data from it, and then we can use it to make the sea glide, which that's going to come later on down the road, but eventually we will make the sea glide. Actually, sooner rather than later, because I need that sea glide. Got ourselves some titanium located in the limestone deposit, which is okay, I guess, but we don't really need it. Because we, seriously, we got metal lying all over it. There we go, copper, that's what I need. If I remember before, copper was one of those things that took me forever to collect. Just because I couldn't find it anywhere, I don't know why. Okay, bladderfish, this guy is food, so I'm going to hold on to him. In fact, let's go ahead and get this guy too. I think that's a peeper. Get back here, peeper. Get back here, don't get away from me. You cannot live for too much longer, come on. There we go, we got a peeper. These guys are food. We are going to eat them, we are going to cook them, and we are going to devour them, and we are going to love them. Either that or adapt to the point where we can love them. Whoa, okay. The fact that those guys are so close to me, I don't like that. Okay, let's go ahead and go back to the life pod. As you can see, it's actually starting to get dark. And yeah, we need to, actually, we're okay on food. We really need water. But thankfully, I think we can make some water. Let's see what we need in order to, okay, let's go and make the glass. Okay, bleach, we need common coral, which actually should not be hard to gather. So let's go ahead and take a look, see if we can find some common coral. And then the common coral can be used to make bleach. Oh, God. I do not like going out here at nighttime. I'm just going to say that right now. I mean, it looks really cool. Don't get me wrong, but it's freaky. It's really, really freaky. I mean, look at this. You can't see a thing. Okay, so where do we have common coral in this area? And by the way, in case you're curious, even though the world is pretty much the same, every time you start out the game, you actually start in a different location. Which is something I found out when I was trying to do this the first time. Because I was really confused, and when I jumped out of the life pod, I was not in the same place I had started before. So yeah, you start out someplace completely different, completely new. So it's actually kind of cool, because it adds a little bit of variety to the game. Which, actually, in a game like this, it's not exactly much needed, because this game is like has all sorts of variety already. But still, I mean, I think it's kind of cool that they add extra variety to the game and they keep that, or they take that into account. Anyway, we need to find some coral. Back in the first starter area, it's all over the place, but it seems in this one, it doesn't seem to be anywhere. And we really need a flashlight too. We can't go very deep down. Let's see. You look like more food, so you get back here. Come on, come on, come on. Haha, almost. Where'd he go? Ah, dang it. This always happens to me, man. It's like, I think I got something, but no, he's gone. I don't see coral. Okay, you know what? We'll wait till daybreak. That way we can see a little bit better. For now, we are going to head back to the life pod, and we are going to get ourselves situated a little bit better. So how are y'all doing today? Hopefully I'll actually get, ooh, a whole fish. Hopefully I'll get a little bit farther in the series this time around, because last time I only finished, actually I had 2 episodes recorded, but for some reason I didn't post it. I guess I'm thinking I just did not like it, or I did not like the way it came out. So yeah, this time around we are going to hopefully make something better, and hopefully keep this going for a little bit longer if you guys like it. Okay, whole fish, it's a gelatinous fish, yay. Okay, we also have cooked peeper. Might as well make that too. Food is food, right? I'll be honest, I'd rather starve than eat this stuff, because this is like, I don't know. This is, would any of you eat this cooked whole fish? Whole fish. There we go. And I guess I don't really need to eat, but it restores a little bit of water too. In the filtered water, boom. Okay, so we have a little too much on the titanium right now. Let's see, blueprints. Okay, so this is the stuff I've discovered so far, which is nice. Okay, floating air pump. Pumps air into pipes, acts as a starting point for a pipe chain. Okay, that is what we're going to need to get oxygen into our base much later on down the road, but we don't have to worry about that yet. For now, let's just get started, okay? We need to worry about making materials so that we can progress through the game. Okay, so air bladder. Okay, we need silicone rubber. Silicone, oh, that's right. I remember where to get silicone. We need creep vines. So we're going to have to go locate some creep vines, and then we can go ahead and make the silicone. But equipment is what we need right now. Equipment, ooh, deployables. Okay, I need another battery. Actually, that's very easy. Let's go ahead and just get a couple more acid mushrooms. In fact, I think I have one in here, but we need 2, don't we? We do. Oh, I have the battery with me. Of course. Okay. So how do I, right mouse, okay, right mouse button, stop hitting the escape button, dang it. Okay, so equipment, pipe, floating air pump, no, tools, flashlight, scanner, but oh, I really need the laser cutter, or not the laser cutter, but the which one was it, Wow, I'm already getting scatterbrained, man. This always happens to me. Okay, oxygen tank. There we go. That's what we need. And yeah, it is the scanner that I do need. So let's go and make the scanner. And let's go and equip the oxygen tank, which actually I'm pretty sure it does that on its own. Let's just double check. Yep, the oxygen tank is equipped. So now we can survive longer. As for the scanner, it's already down on my hotbar. And let's see what we can scan. Is it daytime yet? Nope. That's okay. You know what? We're going in anyway. Woo! This place is freaky looking. Have I mentioned that? Dang, man. I would not survive a minute on this planet. I mean, look at this. Coral. Look at that. We got some coral. Okay. Let's see if I can just mine this with my fist. No? I have to have the knife in order to do that. And the knife, we need silicone for. So it looks like the first stop will be right over here to the creep vine forest or kelp forest or whatever it is they call these biomes in this game. I don't know yet. But I do like that I can stay down longer. I do move very, very slow. Ooh. Suggests a quantum detonation has occurred in the aurora. That's not good. The central dark matter reactor. That is not good. Supercritical state. AT minus. Poor aurora. 10, 9, 8. Goodbye, aurora. 7, 6, 5. It was nice knowing you. 3, 2. Well, one thing is for certain, if there was anybody still alive on that ship, they're definitely dead now. I just hope I'm not the only one who made it out alive, but I probably am. Anyway, back to our objectives now that our home ship has pretty much been destroyed. Ah, frame rate. No, frame rate. Don't do this to me. This always happens when I enter into a new place. Okay, creep vine clusters. I cannot say clusters. This is what we need in order to make the silicone. So let's go ahead and gather as many of these as we can at the moment. Come on, come on. That is... okay, that's plenty. And we are going to use that to make the silicone so we can make the knife. And the knife can be used to gather the coral, and we can use the coral in order to make filtered water, I guess, or bleach. So yeah, the bleach is... actually, it's kind of good because it is a very, very good water source. In fact, it's better than what I can make using other resources right now. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do to make the water. As for the food, I'm just going to stick to eating fish around until I get... I think you can actually grow farms and have, like, biological things and whatnot. It's pretty cool. But that will come much later when I'm actually doing the base and whatnot. Again, if I make it that far. Okay, a waterproof locker. Actually, let's go ahead and make ourselves one of these. These things have a tendency to float out of the life pod, though, which is strange. Okay, I can't even pick it up yet because I've got so much clogging up my inventory. I need to... okay, let's go ahead and just store a couple of these. Come on, store, 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 store. There we go. Now let's pick this up. But we're just going to move it to right there. And in here... oh, we can name it. Let's name it The Locker. There we go. Much more original now, right? And let's go and store up some of this titanium because we have a lot of it with us. Okay. And okay, what we're going to do now, basic materials, glass. I think I need some glass actually in order to make the, which one? There's something I wanted to make with glass. Okay, silicone for the fins. Oh, the flashlight, that's all right, but I need to make a battery first. Okay, so let's go ahead and make the glass. And let's also make some silicone so that we can make our fins and also work toward getting our speed up in the ocean, because right now we are very, very slow. Okay, we also need some water again. Cured food, salt deposit. Oh, that's right. I forgot you could do that. As for water, we just need bleach in order to make that. In order to make bleach, common coral. Okay, yeah, that's right. But we also need the knife in order to get the coral. So, knife? Where's the knife? Okay, oxygen tank, fins... that's the silicone. The knife is not down here. Tools. Oh, of course it's a tool. What am I thinking, man? There we go. Now we can make our knife. Knife work, guys. Knife work. Sorry, I had to say it. I know that was lame. Okay, thermometer, pipe, steel suit, radiation. Okay, fins, more silicone. Let's go ahead and pick up a couple more creep vines. That should be enough. There I go, hit and escape again. Why is my instinct to hit escape? I just don't get it. Okay, scanner. And no, okay, there we go. And not advanced, there we go. Silicone rubber. Oh, that makes two of them. One of them makes two. So why did we not have enough of, oh, we need two clusters to make one. That's what it is. Whoops. I guess I should actually read what is on the screen instead of just making assumptions and yeah. And let's see, fins. There we go. We got ourselves the fins. Now we are better equipped to do some swimming. And only one more thing I would like to gather, but we just need another battery for that, which that will be very easy to get. And down we go. Woo! Welcome back into the water, guys. Did you miss this place? Well, I'm telling you guys, you are not going to miss it for long because this game is all about exploring in the water. And we're going to get so lost in here. We are going to die by all sorts of creatures. We are going to drown. We are going to die. But it's going to be fun. So, yeah, hopefully we can continue the series. Hopefully, hopefully I actually keep interest in it in order to continue the series, because that's one of the biggest things with me. Oh, stay down below. No doubt that guy's going to attack. No, he didn't attack. Okay. Because that's one of the biggest things with me when I play games is that sometimes I tend to lose interest. And if I lose interest in the games, it's kind of hard for me to get back into the game. So yeah, I don't want that to happen with this one, because this is a really cool game and there is a lot in the game that I want to explore. But the key thing is getting past the beginning parts, and that is my biggest struggle right now, is making it past the... What is that? Whoa, boy. No, you stay away from me. I don't like you, okay? We are not friends. That is not okay. Stay back. Stay back. Woo. Okay, so we encountered our first deadly enemy. I don't like him. Oh, I'm going to say that now. I do not like him. Not one bit. There we go. Four should be enough for now. We have the batteries. Actually, six. How big is this? Okay, you know, that's fine. Whew. Okay, that was a bit freaky. And where did that sea glide fragment go? I want to find that sea glide fragment before we move on, since we're here. Okay, so here's the sea glide fragment. There might actually be something else over here, so let's go and take a look. That's the sea glide. Let's go ahead and scan that. There we go. And we need two of these. Let's see if there's one more in here. Maybe we'll get lucky. Does not appear to be anything in this, unfortunately, but let's go and take a look around this wreckage, because wreckages are generally where we find this kind of stuff. And we're going to need to search out a bunch of fragments, like for submarines and all sorts of insane stuff. So we're going to have to keep our eyes out for wreckages. And I think they can just be lying around randomly too. It's just I have no idea where we need to look for that. So yeah, it's going to be a lot of exploring. That's kind of what I see in the future of this series, is exploration, and dying. A lot of both. Okay, so let's go and head on back to the life pod. And we will use our newly acquired resources to make some things. And yeah, hopefully things that will enable us to survive a bit longer in this dreaded ocean landscape. Board the escape pod, inventory secured. Okay. So we got common coral, we got ourselves a couple acid mushrooms, and I think I have myself the copper. Good, so we can make the battery under electronics. Battery, there it is. And the battery can be used to make the flashlight. So, flashlight, where you at? There we go. Now we can see in the dark. Woo, yay, we can survive, or actually we can see how scary the ocean is at night. That's great. That's just really grand. Looks like we need some water. I'll be right back. Okay, so right over here, that guy right there. As you can see, they kind of gather resources themselves too, but that is the guy who attacked me earlier. He is a nasty creature, and he needs to back off. You don't come anywhere near me. You understand me? You stay back there. Oh, nope, he's coming for me. We need to get out of here. Oh, crap. What do you want with me, man? I did nothing to you. I was just taking a look at you. I just wanted to see what you look like so I can show the kind people on the other end of the screen what you were. Stay away from me. God. Stay away from me. Stop harassing me. Leave me alone. Let's get in here before he kills me. Oh, boy. Like, what did I do, man? What did I do to deserve that? You know what? Nothing. I did nothing. Because this place is an alien planet. That's what you kind of have to expect on an alien planet, is that everything wants to kill you. And yeah, he definitely wants to kill me, that's for sure. There is no doubt about that one. Oh, okay, so this is the stuff we can make. We can make a current generator. We can make, okay, all sorts of, okay, that's the habitat stuff. A sign, wall locker, okay. Compartment, and I think they added things since the last time I was looking at this. Synthetic fibers, bleach, okay. Back to our crafting. And let's see what our next focus is going to be. We have ourselves the light source. We have ourselves the scanner. And let's see what else we have. Like, we repair tool, we definitely want to get this thing back online. Our life pod, I mean, when I say this thing. Air bladder, chemical reaction produces lighter than air. Okay, personal buoyancy. Maybe, I don't know. A flare, we don't really need that right now. Habitat builder, eventually we will get into making that, but for now I'm not going to worry about it. Laser cutter, we'll need that to access areas later on. See, grab spear, sea glide, that is what I am currently going after, I guess. And also a beacon too, because I want to go ahead and make a beacon for my I don't really need a beacon for this, but no, actually forget the beacon, we don't need a beacon. Okay, so let's see if that I don't know what that thing was. Let's see if he actually is keeping his distance away from me now, and hopefully I can swim in peace. Okay, so one thing about the scanner, what you can do, you can actually scan other creatures as well. And the creatures, like, you can gather information on them, but it's kind of hard to do with hostile monsters like these guys. I think these things are called gastropods, if I'm not mistaken. I can't read it, though. Why is it not working? Come on, come on. Teach me. Enlighten me. I want to hear what the gastropod has to offer, what he is about. If he has any resources I can gather from. And it does not look like that is the case, though. Okay, okay, fine, fine, fine. Oh, that's because I'm using the flashlight, because I'm an idiot. Great. Trying to scan him with a flashlight, dang it. Why do I do this to myself? Why do I do this to myself? Okay, let's try the scan. Ready? Let's scan him. Come on, come on. Ooh, stay away though, stay away. There we go. Oh, gastropod, it's gastropod. I have to get really close to him to scan him, so that is actually not exactly... Okay, okay. It saves my progress at least. Nope, you stay away from me. You stay away from me. So thankfully I don't have to do it all in one sitting. I can come back to him if I need to escape him. Okay, almost got him, almost got him. Whoop! He's about to attack again. Horrible, horrible things. Oh no! Okay, I need to go down, I think. Yeah, that was a good call. Woo! I don't even want to go in there because I know that that stuff is going to just outright destroy me. Okay, come on, we were so close. Let's go ahead and finish this off. Oh no! That's what that does. It hurts, and it hurts bad. Okay, come on, come on, let's finish you off. There we go, perfect. We got some information on the gastropod. Let's go ahead and see what he's about, but actually first, let's make our way back to the life pod. All right, the gastropod. Slow-moving life form capable of filling the water with a poisonous and corrosive compound capable of dissolving even synthetic fibers. Filtration system. Multiple gill layers appear to render this creature impervious to the noxious clouds it produces. Algae gland. A bulbous sac like an appendage on the rear end. A luminescent yellow algae grows inside the sac and produces the poisonous compound. Abdominal muscles contract when the creature is stimulated, causing the algae gland to emit a noxious compound into the surrounding water. And then pelvic fins, okay, so that's pretty much what I expect. They appear to be social in nature and may even use their emissions in their relationship rituals. That is not a relationship I want to be a part of, that is for sure. Okay, water. We still have not gotten any water. Crap. Okay, so we need some bleach. Let's see if I can make some bleach. Yes, I can make some bleach, okay. So apparently all we need is bleach and we can make some water with the bleach. Woo! So we are in the clear, guys. We are in the clear. Preparing the day's water ration ahead of time will help ensure against dehydration. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Thanks for the tip. We don't need no tips from you, actually. We need a lot of tips. I need to know everything. I don't know anything about this game. Okay, inventory. There we go. Woo! 40% off of that one. That was awesome. Okay, let's go ahead and go back out. It is still nightfall, though, so yeah, it's going to be a while before we actually make any progress in this game. But you know what? That's okay. Actually, I think I'm going to go ahead and end this episode right here. I know we didn't exactly get a whole lot done, but we at least got a start. We got some tools. And yeah, hopefully in the next episode, we'll actually find that sea glide and we'll make some progress. So, if you like this episode, do me a favor, hit that like button. It would mean the world to me. If you like this kind of content, go ahead and subscribe to me because I post 2 videos daily, or at least I try to. And I'll see you guys next time. Thank you guys so much for watching and take care.